and Merry Christmas to you all. We begin with Christmas because it comes generally as one of the most memorable occasions for Christian families. But for Apaka Abugri in a village near Boko, the Christmas over the years has been all but pleasant. Joy News' Mahmoud Mohammed Nuruddin visited his dilapidated residence in the Binduri district of the Upper East region and reports of a life in abject poverty.
Sound mind, sane but blind, Apaka Abugri searches for his walking stick to do the usual at his wife's grave. Pray for her. Amalsum died about 16 years ago. Mr. Abugri returns to his room where he would sleep all day when Christians like him are celebrating the birth of Christ, a joyous occasion called Christmas. He has no place to go to celebrate the Christmas, neither will anyone bring gifts to make life better for him, at least for one day.
I always sit down and imagine how lively life would have been if people were around me. But there is no one in the house. If you people hadn't come, I would have been indoors until the sun rises before I come out. I will be here, and if any passerby gives me money, and I would then send someone to buy food for me.
That brings Abugri's memory back to the time his wife was alive. But now he needs nothing but food to also celebrate.
As a blind man, my priority is food and little drink. As for meat, it is a secondary matter. Our elders say a stranger is asked whether they have eaten, not whether they have taken meat. If you don't see food, how can you be asking for meat?
He was born in the village of Tisnatenga at a time when births were not formally recorded. He does not know his age, but remembers he witnessed Nkrumah's regime. He has not had a child in his entire life. Nobody cares about him, and he may have to live in this dilapidated structure for the rest of his life. But Mr. Abugri knows that whoever is kind to the poor lends to the Lord, and he would reward them for what they have done. That is the hope that rise in Abugri before our team left his residence. A report by Mohammed Nuruddin.